afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is October 6th. It is Monday, and because we got a lot of your questions, what we're going to do again today is we're going to answer some of your questions today, tomorrow, and then Thursday, just so we can fire away, get them answered right away, because I know how important they are to you. Now, a reminder to you guys, we don't know the answer to everything, and I am more than willing and more than welcome to tell you that. So if we don't know the answer to something, what we like to do is usually give you a link or a referral off to someone else who does know the answer, because we really want to get you help. But before we even get into the questions, just want you to take out a look here. This is actually right behind our condo here. And you can see that some of the leaves are actually starting to turn here in Connecticut. And it's really pretty. So in about a week and a half to 2 weeks, this is all going to start to really, really be full color. But I thought that we'd show it to you. This is just about, maybe it's what, about two-tenths of a mile outside of our condo. There's a little trail that comes out here. By the way, our condo is for rent. So if anyone wants to move to Danbury, Connecticut, please send us an email and we'll hook you up. We'll show you some pictures and all that sort of stuff. So let's get into your questions. Here we go. Allie asks, Allie is or was a smoker and she's been chewing Nicorette gum for a long time. And she wants to know if there's anyone who's had trouble getting rid of Nicorette gum and if they had any sort of stomach issues with the Nicorette gum. Yes, I've heard of people having stomach issues, not only with Nicorette gum, but just with regular chewing gum. People have experienced things like upset stomach. I've also heard people possibly contribute that to ulcers, so I would be very careful about chewing gum. And the second thing is, you know, how do you let the gum go? Well, here's the deal. Some of you guys may not know this, but I used to be a cigarette smoker. And the biggest challenge about smoking cigarettes and releasing that kind of charge that you have on cigarettes is this, is that you have to identify what you would do if you weren't. So that's kind of the phrasing here. So what you would do if you weren't. And that was kind of what helped me get out of cigarettes and stop that really, really terrible habit. And so what I decided to do was I said, I was afraid that if I stopped smoking, I wouldn't, one, have time. At the place I was working, I wouldn't be able to go out and just kind of relax for, 5 minutes or so. I was afraid that I wouldn't be able to do anything while I was driving in my car. I was afraid, what if I ate a meal and then, after the meal I wanted to have a cigarette, like what would I do? And those were some of the fears that I had about, what I would do. And what I kind of did was I went through a process of, well, what would I do if I wasn't smoking cigarettes? Could I still take a break? Could I still, go outside and take some deep breaths? And that worked for me. With driving, I started to replace that with audio tapes. So you can take, we have audio on this program. We have hundreds of audio programs that we've done over the period of 2 years. You can take that, put it on a CD, and you can replace that information, that good information, with this negative habit. So that's really going to be the best way to do it, is to think about what you would do if you weren't. And then that, hopefully, Allie, will give you a little bit of a stepping stone to move on to the next level. Next up, Christina asks, I have two questions. Great. What's the deal with organic young coconuts versus conventional? Are the conventional ones really dipped 3 times in various chemicals? Have there been any lab tests on these? This is an awesome question. It's so timely. You really hit it on the head. Matt Amsden, the interview that I did with Matt Amsden last week, he talked about the fact that he was so ticked off that people kept, saying there was chemicals, that these coconuts were dipped in formaldehyde, that he actually got them tested. He went out and he bought, a handful of Thai coconuts and tested them for formaldehyde. His results were no, they have no formaldehyde. Now here's the deal, it doesn't say that they have other chemicals, but it does say that there's no formaldehyde. So at least in that batch of Thai coconuts, they were non-organic. At least in that batch of non-organic Thai coconuts, they did not have formaldehyde. So we can stop spreading that rumor. Next up, second question for Christina is, you said you blended your green juice in a blender, and I've read that Vitamix destroys nutrients and enzymes more than a twin gear juicer, but then some people say you can juice with a Vitamix and strain through a nut bag, and if you drink it quick, it is all good. All right, here's the deal. The less abrasion and the less friction that you're going to have the less nutrients that are going to be destroyed by heat. I'm not entirely super concerned about, you know, the amount of nutrients that can be destroyed by putting it through a Vitamix as opposed to a Green Star juicer. I happen to really like the Vitamix. I think it's really easy to put all this stuff into the Vitamix, blend it up, and put it through a nut bag. I find it a lot easier than putting it into a juicer and dealing with cleaning the juicer and all that. Are some of the nutrients and enzymes destroyed? Sure. Is it still a great green juice and it's still really, really, really nutritious? Absolutely. So use the use the tools that you have, and if you want to upgrade, then go ahead, get a Twin Star and a Vitamix. But you know, right now the Vitamix really works for us, and we have a juicer, we have a Champion, and we have a Jack-O-Lane juicer. We don't even use them anymore because we rely solely on the Vitamix. So we really get a lot of use out of that machine. The last question is, Fred asks, it's a weird question. Yes, it is a little weird question, but I want to answer it. About six months ago, I was pooping usually around 3 times a day. Back then I was in a rush and did not chew my food nearly as much as I should have. I've kept the same diet, been chewing more, and noticed that I'm only pooping once a day. Not worried about it, but could it be because he's chewing the food better? You know what, Fred, I have no idea. I really don't think that chewing the food more would slow down digestion. Chewing the food more, I think, would actually speed up, because there's more surface area around the fiber that you have in your stomach and in your digestive system. So I would really consider looking at your whole entire diet program as a whole, exercise as well, sleeping as well, hydration particularly. See if that's a factor, and maybe you can come up with your answer. So that was a pretty long episode. I answered a lot of questions. There's a lot of knowledge in this head. I need to get it out to you guys. So please keep asking questions. Your question of the day is this. We have a brand new logo coming out for the Renegade Health Show. Nicole has designed, by the way, Nicole to NB Creative. You got to check out her stuff.
Wait for the wind to go by. You're like black though.
What do you mean?
You're black.
What do you mean?
You're black. Maybe it'll come out better. Here, let me stand there.
That's fine.
No, okay.
Nicole at NB, where was that? Okay. Nicole at NB Creative, she does a great job with logos, but she gave me 3 samples to look at, and so what I want to know from you guys is, which one do you like the most, and what could we add to any one of them to make it even better? So this is, and I'm going to post them down below, the images, you can take a look. That's your question of the day. This is Kevin Gianni, Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world, one show at a time.